Man, do I love history. It's time for another Badasses of World War II, Part 10. Let me introduce Captain Jesus Villamor. Now, he is part of the Philippine Army Air Corps in World War II, and on December 12, 1941, he did something pretty damn incredible. You see, Captain Villamor flew this. This is a P-26 pea shooter of World War II, and that was one of the very first fully metal airplanes designed for fighting capabilities. But when I say it's a combat fighter, I'm using probably some of the loosest definitions of that word as you can possibly use to describe an aircraft. When going up against the Mitsubishi Zero of the Japanese Empire, it was outgunned, it was outarmored, and it was, well, the Zero had a cockpit. That, you do a barrel on that and hope you have a parachute. But did that stop Captain Villamor? No, sir. He and his other comrades that he was leading in the 6th Pursuit Squadron of the Philippine Army Air Corps took a flight because the first wave of Japanese bombers took out a lot of the air defenses further up on the Philippine Islands, so he's all that's left with his few other fighters. And they said, you know what? We're Filipinos, we're gonna defend our homeland. I don't care if there's 54 bombers and Zeros flying overhead in a combined total, and yes, there were 54 of them. He takes off with his other ones, where he's, like I said, outgunned, out-armored, and he's in an open cockpit. He does something incredible. On December 12, 1941, he records the very first aerial kill of the enemy over the Philippines in the Pacific Theater of the War. And not only that, he shoots down a total of three, one bomber and two Zeros of the four recorded kills on that day in December 12, 1941. And yes, he is a certified World War II badass because not only was he done with that, he was awarded the Distinguished Cross twice and once by General MacArthur personally. General MacArthur actually took him when he left Corridor back to Australia, and guess what he did then? Captain Villamor left Australia because he thought he was going to get new planes, went back to the Philippines, and became a spy, purposely orchestrating propaganda, passive resistance, and guerrilla sabotage for the Philippines until they were liberated later in the war in 1944-45. So, like I said, me, Captain Jesus Villamor, a certified World War II badass. And hey, if you like this video, make sure you hit that like and follow button right around here somewhere. And keep watching for more great videos like this, how history is everywhere, and as always, happy wandering.